That a free press is a vital factor in the democratic process is a given, and Steven Spielberg's new film, The Post, reminds us of just how important media independence really is, especially now. The film is a sort of prequel to All the President's Men, directed by Alan Pakula in 1976, in which Washington Post reporters Woodward and Bernstein ferreted out the truth behind the Watergate break-in. And Spielberg's film ends with that very break-in. In The Post, the veteran director explores the decision of Washington Post publisher Catherine Graham, Meryl Streep, to publish the so-called Pentagon Papers, a top-secret, massively long and detailed State Department document commissioned by Secretary of State Robert McNamara, Bruce Greenwood, on the history of America's involvement in Vietnam. The report has been copied and purloined by State Department analyst Daniel Ellsberg, Matthew Rees. Graham, who inherited the family-run newspaper after the suicide of her husband, is in an extraordinarily difficult position. On the one hand, her editor, Ben Bradley, Tom Hanks, is urging her to publish or be damned, even though the New York Times, which also received the material from Ellsberg, has been slapped with an injunction by the Attorney General, and both Graham and Bradley face prison sentences if they publish the documents. So, why publish? Because the papers reveal that five American presidents, Truman, Eisenhower, Kennedy, Johnson, and now Nixon, lied to the Congress and to the people about American involvement in an increasingly unpopular war. But Graham, a Washington socialite, is on close friendly terms with McNamara, just as Bradley was a drinking pal of President Kennedy. And at this very moment, the Post is in the process of a public offering, and the price of the shares will define the paper's immediate future and its ability to hire the journalists who would write exactly this kind of story.
You know, the only couple I knew that both Kennedy and LBJ wanted to socialize with was you and your husband, and you owned the damn paper. But that's the way things worked. Politicians and the press, they trusted each other so they could go to the same dinner party and drink cocktails and tell jokes while there was a war raging in Vietnam.
I don't know what we're talking about. I'm not protecting Lyndon.
No, you got his former Secretary of Defense, Robert McNamara, the man who commissioned this study. He's one of about a dozen party guests out on your patio.
I'm not protecting any of them. I'm protecting the paper.
As scripted by Liz Hanna and Josh Singer, this is riveting stuff, and even though it's set in what for many might seem the distant past, the themes are probably even more relevant today than they were in the 1970s, given that this is the era of fake news and the Trump presidency. Spielberg's thesis is that a free press that is openly and clearly nonpartisan and not beholden to the White House or the government is of vital importance. And once the decision to publish is taken, against the advice of the Post's in-house lawyers, Spielberg delights in depicting the way in which the paper works, the frantic journalists writing to a deadline, the setting of the type, the printing, folding, delivering of a newspaper that would shed a light on a secret and vindictive administration. The Post is the kind of film that used to be far more common in the past, when Hollywood treated its audience as grown-ups to an extent that seems hopelessly idealistic today. It's to Spielberg's credit that he wanted to tell this story and that he and his formidable cast tell it so very well. I'm giving The Post 4 stars.